great words of the late Yogi Berra. Before I speak, I'd like to say something. Folks, we have a talented administrative team that is second to none. These people are the first to take the blame when things don't go so well and are not often recognized for their commitment in supporting our student culture of growth, care, and innovation as Lovell works to become a destination district. Please join me in recognizing Mr. Hilliker, Mr. Coney, Dr. Krause, Mr. Griffith, and the entire administrative team for all their hard work and dedication to our schools. I'd like to take this time to reflect on who we are as a Loveland community. And allow me to be stark and candid for a brief moment. It is a fact that 50% of all teenage students have been legally drunk. And perhaps it is time as an entire community to send a unified message that teen alcohol consumption is unhealthy, unsafe, and unacceptable. Perhaps it is time as an entire community to talk openly about the ills of addiction and be a more compassionate people in accepting this reality. Perhaps it is time that we as a community widen the conversation circles and own the fact that while some advocate against this unhealthy behavior, it is simply not enough. Perhaps as an entire community, it is okay to admit that perhaps we have fallen a bit short. Perhaps as an entire community, we come to terms that Loveland is not some snow globe society insulated from addiction and troubles, as some might believe, but rather, we are a community that is just as vulnerable to these ills as anywhere else in the world. Folks, there is an underbelly here, and perhaps as an entire community, it is time to recognize that it is acceptable to talk openly about this for the benefit of our children and their future. These conversations start caregiver to child, neighbor to neighbor, street to street, subdivision to subdivision. And that, my friends, is how a revolution gets started. Now let's flip the conversation around. Now let's talk about what this community does exceptionally well. And now I'd like to spend the next couple minutes talking with the class of 2017 primarily. I want to talk about bringing Loveland to the world. Now let's break this down. Each of you have enjoyed an enriched student experience. Growing up in this amazing community, thousands of people are responsible for you to be able to sit in these seats today. Thousands of people, some of them are known to you and many are not, have volunteered their time, talent, and treasure in order to enrich your life experience. This effort is extraordinary, and you have been the consumers of this collective goodness. Now it is time for you to bring Loveland to the world. Now it is your turn to be the purveyors of this goodness of Loveland, the goodness that you have enjoyed so much. Now it is time for you to donate your time and talents for the benefit of others in the world, so others can experience the gifts you have enjoyed. Bring Loveland to the world. There are others in this world who have not had their lives enriched, who thirst for care, who thirst for the very opportunities you have been so blessed to experience. Consider it your opportunity. In fact, consider it your obligation to bring Loveland to the world. Because quite frankly, the world may need the goodness of Loveland now more than ever. Thank you and God bless the class of 2017.